The exact questions and kind of the difficulty level of those questions will be different based on their developmental position. So if they're in like pre-K or K, phonological awareness will be done with very simple types of tasks, identifying what the onset sound is in a word, or hearing rhymes in words, or pulling a word that's a compound word apart. As we get older, our skills are getting more advanced, and what we should be able to do should be more advanced. So it'll be a little more challenging for those kids. But it's important to realize that even in that one skill that we measure to find characteristics of dyslexia, we measure that in all of our kids to see if we have that, as well as these other skill sets that we've been talking about. A child brings a unique set of strengths to the table. So in some examples, a child who can learn and memorize words very quickly and efficiently and have a large sight vocabulary could make it a long way. And historically, when we look at the research and the prevalence of dyslexia, it wasn't until those kids got into the late second to third grade that we would often see them start to pop up. We often see another group that pops up in the fourth to fifth grade when we get into more multisyllabic words, so words that have multiple syllables that we have to attack. So as the challenge of the reading task gets more complex, even kids who have a lot of strengths to bring to the table to compensate and kind of mask their underlying problems will start to surface. And so it's important for us to remember that just because I didn't show problems in kindergarten, first, or second, doesn't mean that I can't be dyslexic and show in your fifth grade classes. And I might have even been getting some pretty good instruction all the way up there, and my teachers were really good in doing what was right for me at that time.